clearly I'm going to follow up a two-part series on addition with subtraction. The nature of subtraction is exactly the same as the nature of addition. Units of measure make it really restrictive, and we can only subtract things that have the same unit of measure. So for example, 8 cows minus 5 cows, of course it's going to be 3 cows. And this shows the first definition of subtraction, which is taking away. And this definition restricts us to reality. We can't take away something that isn't there. So for example, if we started with 3 cows, we couldn't possibly take away 8 cows. That's just insanity. But we know 3 minus 8 exists. So how can we bridge reality with the abstract when it comes to subtraction? The number line. Just like addition, subtraction can be moving on the number line, but where addition was moving to the right, subtraction will be moving to the left. Let's take 8 minus 5. 8 minus 5. It's going to be 3. And that's how the number line works for subtraction. So how do we handle taking away something that isn't there, right? Let's look at 3 minus 8. 3 minus or take away 8. It's going to be negative 5. And now we can see how subtraction will work on the number line. But what about working with negative numbers? We go back to where we use the definition of negative as opposite. And it's going to be important to follow your ears and not your eyes. You have to hear the math sentence. Follow the directions. 8 minus 3, got it. 3 minus 8, got that. But what about 8 minus negative 3? 8 minus negative 3, it's going to be 11. What? I thought we were taking away. Well, we were simply following directions. It's true. Even 3 minus negative 8. 3 minus negative 8. Also 11. Holy cow, what's going on here? We followed the directions. We cannot argue with our process. 8 minus negative 3 is the same as 3 minus negative 8. But what's even weirder is that they're both the same as 3 plus 8 and 8 plus 3. And now we have proven another definition of subtraction, which is adding the opposite. Let that sink in for a minute. Taking away is the same as adding the opposite. That is some heavy stuff, especially when you go back to 8 cows minus 5 cows. It's the same as 8 cows plus negative 5 cows. And there we go with those -5 cows again. It's such a crazy concept. What if the number line doesn't cut it? Back to manipulatives. Remember, we need to master the concept of zero to handle manipulatives. Positive, negative, zero. Subtraction is taking away. So 8 minus 3, 8, 8 yellows, minus, take away, 3, 3 yellows, 5. Got it? What about negative 8 minus negative 3? Read it properly to hear it, and then start with negative 8, 8 reds, minus, take away, negative 3, 3 reds, okay? Negative 5. Negative 8 minus negative 3 is negative 5. And here is where subtraction can get a bit nuts with manipulatives. What about 8 minus negative 3? Start with 8 yellows, and we need to take away 3 reds? How does that even work? There are no reds to take away. So that means we need to add 3 zeros before we can take away the proper number of reds. It would look like this. Now remember, we're still looking at the number 8. All we've added is some zeros. So pause for a minute and let that sink in, because it's pretty nuts. Now we can take away our 3 reds. And so we can see that 8 minus negative 3 being 11 in practice. What about 3 minus 8? 3 yellows minus, take away, 8. 8 yellows. How are we going to take away 8 yellows? What do? We add a bunch of zeros until we have enough yellows to take away, and it would look like this. Now remember, you're still looking at the number 3. It's so weird. But now you can take away the 8 yellows. And what do you have left? 5 reds. Negative 5. Yeah, 3 minus 8 is negative 5. Now this all still works. If we change that subtraction to adding the opposite, but you have to hear it. 3 minus 8 is the same as 3 plus negative 8. And then we go back to our video on addition to see how that works with manipulatives. It's the same result. It's negative 5. What about negative 3 minus 8? Start with negative 3. Take away 8 yellows. There are no yellows that we can take away. So how do we do that? Add a bunch of zeros, right? Remember, right now you're still looking at the number negative 3. So negative 3 minus 8. We can take away our 8 yellows and boom, we got negative 11. And this also still works with changing subtraction to adding the opposite, right? Negative 3 minus 8 is the same as negative 3 plus negative 8. The result is still negative 11. And that's how manipulatives will work with subtraction. If your children can practice and understand this, be super impressed, because this is not simple. There is a lot of abstract concepts here. And remember, don't practice until you get it right. Practice until you cannot get it wrong. Be patient and be impressed.